a family died over an iPhone. Teenagers basically set a house on fire, and they set the wrong one on fire at that. Put up the picture full mask. Colorado teen pleaded guilty in his role in setting a family's home on fire after mistakenly targeting that home in a revenge plot over a stolen iPhone. Dillon Siebert, who is not pictured here because of age, pleaded guilty to his murder charge after accepting a plea deal with prosecutors. This individual, alongside Kevin Bowie on the left, 18, and Gavin Seymour on the right, 18 as well, were all charged in connection to the house fire in a Denver, Colorado suburb. The fire occurred on August 5th, 2020. August 5th, 2020, when Bowie, Seymour, and Siebert wanted to get revenge against the people they believed stole Bowie's cell phone in a robbery. Police say the accused teens used an app to track the phone and Google searches to pinpoint the home of the family of immigrants, but they targeted the wrong home. The teens told investigators they did not know who lived in the home and only learned the identities of the victims after the fire. Well, here's the family. That's who they killed. The fire took the lives of Beye's wife, Hassan Diol, 25. The infant daughter, Hawa, as well as Hassan's brother, Jibril Diol, 29. His wife, Arja Diol, 23. And their daughter, Khadija Diol, 2 years of age. 17-year-old Dillon was sentenced to 10 years in prison on Wednesday in Denver court for his role in the deaths of that entire family, those family members. He will also face a suspended sentence of 26 years if he violates the terms of that sentence. He was also sentenced separately Wednesday in juvenile court to serve 3 years in the Division of Youth Services. Bowie and Seymour's cases are still pending, and they are facing first degree murder, attempted murder, arson, burglary charges. A whole family. There's a lot I can say. The reality is this family should be alive. And yeah, it's ironic in a very perverted way that they were trying to kill another family and ended up killing this one. Now, we'll say this. This kind of reckless disregard, this lack of value for life itself is learned. It is learned. There is a significant disconnect between the humanity of who they are and the humanity that currently exists. Over an iPhone, who taught you that was valuable? Who taught you that meant something? An iPhone. All right, Sharon, thoughts here.
Yeah, when you first started telling the story, my mind was going towards kids. Dumb teenagers. It's just rite of passage stuff. And then you put up the picture of that beautiful family that is no more. And it's that last part, Dr. Richey. Every day we have to reinforce what matters to children, to everyone.
Yeah.